to present the State of the University Address. It's my honor to present to you President Sidney A. McPhee.
Well, good morning. I'm certainly delighted to welcome each of you to our annual fall faculty meeting as we begin a new and indeed exciting academic year. Now, each fall for the past 15 years, it's been my pleasure to be among the first to welcome back our returning faculty and staff, and certainly extend a warm greeting to our newest employees. Today in my remarks, I would like to accomplish three simple goals. First, I would like to highlight a few university achievements from this past year. Next, I would like to give an update on our ongoing efforts regarding our number one strategic priority, our quest for student success. And finally, as I do annually, I would like to reflect on some of the challenges and opportunities that lie ahead in the new academic year. But first, let me take just a few moments to recognize some individuals who are extremely important to this institution and who are committed to our mission and are invaluable to me in working to ensure the successful management and operation of this great university. I'll begin by introducing my senior executive team, a group of outstanding individuals who serve as my key advisors and are involved in much of the overall decision making on our campus. So please hold your applause until each group is recognized. You've already met our Chief Academic Officer, Dr. Brad Bartell, University Provost, Mr. John Cothran, Senior Vice President, Dr. Deb Sells, Vice President for Student Affairs and Vice Provost for Enrollment and Academic Services, Mr. Joe Bales, Vice President for University Advancement, Mr. Andrew Hoffman, Vice President for Marketing and Communication, Mr. Bruce Petrushek, Vice President for Information Technology and Chief Information Officer, and Ms. Kimberly Edgar, Executive Assistant to the President. Please give these senior executives a round of applause. I would also like to take a moment to recognize other members of the President's Cabinet. But before I ask the entire group to stand, I would like to give special recognition to two individuals who have been added to our Cabinet membership since last year. First, Dr. Tricia Farwell, Faculty Senate President for 2015-16, and y'all are really quick. Y'all just get up very quickly and sit down. Stand up so they can see you again, Professor Farwell. Associate Professor of Journalism, she is with us today. Let's give her a round of applause. And I don't see her, I know she's in the audience, but Ms. Lindsay Pierce. Is Lindsay here? Lindsay is our Student Government Association President for 2015. Let's give her a round of applause in absentia. Now, will all the other members of the President's Cabinet, will you stand? I see many of you in the audience, and let's give you a round of applause for your good work and involvement with our university. Next, I'd like to introduce our deans. And as you, perhaps those of you who are veterans, you will see from last year, we've asked all of our deans to join us on the podium. They are the chief academic officers of the colleges and schools and do an exceptional job. First, Dr. Robert Fisher, Dean, College of Basic and Applied Science, and just remain standing so we can, Thank you. Deans pay more attention to the president than vice presidents. Dr. Harold Whiteside, Dean, College of Behavioral and Health Sciences. Dr. David Urban, Dean, Jennings A. Jones College of Business. Dr. Lana Severs, Dean, College of Education. Dr. Mark Burns, Dean, College of Liberal Arts. Mr. Ken Paulson, Dean, College of Media and Entertainment, formerly the College of Mass Communication. Ms. Bonnie Allen, Dean, University Walker Library. Dr. Mike Boyle, Dean, University College. Dr. John Vile, Dean, University College. And Dr. Jackie Eller, Interim Vice Provost for Research and Dean of the Graduate School. Let's give our deans a round of applause for their leadership. Thank you. Also joining us today on the platform, a great friend of our university, a special guest, is Ms. Kathy Jones, President of the MTSU Foundation Board of Trustees, and you'll be hearing from her a bit later. So let's recognize her now and give a round of applause. Thank you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, as we embark on this new academic year, as an institution, truly there are many reasons to celebrate some absolutely amazing accomplishments this past year by our faculty and staff. Here is just a few brief sampling of the good works. MTSU was recently ranked by nursejournal.org, a very prestigious organization, a social community website for nurses and healthcare professionals nationally, as the top nursing school in Tennessee and the 15th best southeastern in the southeastern region. Our colleagues, for example, at Vanderbilt, by comparison, was ranked 389, and our friends at the University of Tennessee, Knoxville, just the facts, ladies and gentlemen, were ranked 401. Would Dr. Jenny Sauls and the nursing faculty please stand and be recognized for your outstanding work? Thank you. This is the sixth consecutive year that MTSU has had two or more students who have won Fulbright awards. And just by an aside, a year ago, the Chronicle of Higher Education listed MTSU as one of the top 10 Fulbright recipient scholars in the nation. Two this past year brings us to a total of 13 Fulbright scholars in 6 years. This year's winners are from the College of Liberal Arts, Ms. Tandra Martin, who will be studying in South Africa, and Davis Thompson, who will be studying in Slovakia. I think Ms. Martin is here. Ms. Davis is unable to make it. Ms. Martin, are you here? Would you stand? Let's give her a round of applause. By the way, you should also know that Ms. Martin was one of the regional and national finalists for the Rhodes Scholars Program last year, one of the most prestigious fellowships in the world. She deserves another round of applause. An MTSU local high school product. We graduated our first class of honors transfer fellows, a program that will grow in importance as the Tennessee Promise Program directs more students to community colleges. MTSU, ladies and gentlemen, remains the number one choice of transfer students in the state of Tennessee. And we're expecting this year another record-breaking year in transfer enrollment. Dean Vile and Ms. Wendy Pilfrey, our interim director of admissions, you've done an outstanding job working with your colleagues. Would you stand? Let's recognize you for your great work. Wendy. The MTSU Experimental Vehicle Lunar Rover team regained its status as the best in the nation during the NASA Human Exploration Rover Challenge and the U.S. Space and Rocket Center. The student-built rover, nicknamed, and like I said, as I practiced it quite a bit, so let me see what your response is. Let me repeat that again. The student-built rover, nicknamed
the Beast,
placed third overall behind Russia and Germany. Professor Saeed Farudistan, would you stand and your team for the outstanding work that you've done over the years? Thank you. Now, in the field of precision agriculture, that's made great technological strides in recent years. Dr. Song Sui was hired to lead MTSU into national prominence in this cutting-edge field. His focus on working with the airspace program to develop sophisticated unmanned technology is yielding impressive results. Dr. Tsui received one of the largest new grants at MTSU, valued at nearly $300,000, to enhance unmanned aerial system-based precision agricultural education and research. Dr. Tsui, your team, would you stand? And let's recognize you for your outstanding work. Ladies and gentlemen, Megatronics Engineering, one of MTSU's newest majors, received a three-year, $615,000 grant from the National Science Foundation for scholarships to help expand the program, which combines mechanical, computer, and electrical engineering, systems integration, and project management. At least 15 incoming freshmen for each of the next 3 years will receive scholarships up to $10,000. Dr. Walter Bowles, head of the program, and his colleagues, would you stand and let's recognize you for your great work. Thank you. The Department of Physics and Astronomy has been nationally recognized for improving undergraduate physics education. And on May 16th of this year, MTSU was one of only three universities honored by the American Physical Society, a physics and science education advocacy organization. They have received awards before, but they continue to rack up outstanding accomplishments. Dr. Ron Henderson and his colleagues, would you stand and let's recognize you for your outstanding work at our university. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, the newest columnist for the Washington Times has an MTSU pedigree. Professor Kobe Juvenil now contributes his views on self-reliance in both column and blog formats for the newspaper. He also recently won the Young Professional Nashville Impact Award from the Nashville Area Chamber of Commerce, an honor given for his dedication to community leadership and professional development. Professor Juvenil, would you stand and let's recognize you for your outstanding work. In March, the MTSU College of Education Research Professor Wilburn Will Clowes, also an MTSU alum, was recognized for decades of work promoting entrepreneurship with this year's John E. Hughes Award for Entrepreneurial Advocacy from the U.S. Association of Small Business and Entrepreneurship. His works show the spirit of entrepreneurship within disciplines throughout the campus. Dr. Klaus, you stand, let's recognize you for your outstanding work. There he is, he's pumping his fists in the air. Well deserved. Dr. Jill Austin in the Jones College of Business was the 2015 Athena Leadership Award winner. She was recognized for her efforts in supporting, honoring, and developing other women leaders. Also nominated were English Professor Emeritus Dr. B. Ann Campbell, Web Management Coordinator Suma M. Clark, English Professor and Director of Women's and Gender Studies, and the new Interim Vice Provost for Academic Affairs, Dr. Tina Johnson, and our own Senior Administrators, Deans Ella and Severs. With Dr. Austin and all the nominees, would you stand and let's recognize you for your outstanding recognition. As you can see, there's a lot. When I said amazing accomplishments, that was just not record. These examples are the evidence. Also in the Jones College, I'd like to note that our accounting graduate student ranked ahead of Vanderbilt and Belmont in terms of pass rate for the CPA exam. This is yet another feather in the cap of this world-class accounting program. With Dr. Stephen Salt and his colleagues from the accounting department, would you stand and let's recognize you for the outstanding work that you do. Thank you. I'd also like to recognize lecturer Laurie Kissinger in the College of Liberal Arts for her leadership with the 40 Days Around the World project, an international digital festival coordinated by VSA Tennessee, the state's organization on arts and disability. And in July of this year, a special quilt that was part of this project was presented at the U.S. Capitol and unveiled to an audience of dignitaries, government officials, and ambassadors, and was accepted into the State Department's Arts in the Embassies program. Ms. Kissinger, would you stand and let's recognize you for your good work. Professor Mark Barr in the Electronics Media Communication Department recently returned from Los Angeles, California, where he was chairman of SIGGRAPH 2015, the largest conference in the world for computer graphics and interactive techniques. More than 20 of MTSU EMC students also attended the international conference. Professor Barr, would you stand and let's recognize you for your leadership worldwide. I'd also like to note that the College of Mass Communication is now, as you heard recently, the College of Media and Entertainment, as it prepares a new generation of students for opportunities in an ever-increasing and changing media environment. The college will build on its strengths of teaching, creative activities, research, and service with an infusion of innovation and hands-on experience. My congratulations to the dean and members of that college for their outstanding work over the years. Dean Paulson and the others, would you all stand and let's recognize you for this wonderful new innovation. Now I'd like to spend just a few moments to recap some of our major academic and programmatic initiatives for the coming year. I am proud that MTSU has been recognized year after year by national publications such as Military Times and GI Jobs magazine as being one of the top universities in the United States for veterans education. But ladies and gentlemen, we also recognize there's much, much more that needs to be done here to better serve this very important community. I believe that the recent creation of the Veterans and Military Family Center on our campus is just the latest step in becoming and making this university the most military-friendly university in America. We just don't want to be one of, we want to be the most. The new 2,600 square foot designated space will be located in the first floor of the KUC, and we will be the largest and most comprehensive veteran and military family center in Tennessee. The official dedication of the center will take place on Thursday, November 5th. And then recently, Governor Bill Haslam announced that MTSU would receive a $91,000 state grant to support its ongoing efforts in vet success. And I personally want to thank MTSU new Senior Advisor for Veteran and Leadership Initiative, retired Lieutenant General Keith M. Huber, and our new Director of the Military Center, Dr. Hillary Miller, for their hard work, and all those faculty and staff who've been working for years to continue to make this an incredible place for our veterans. General Huber, Dr. Miller, and the other staff that and faculty that have been involved with you stand, and let's thank you for your leadership in this very worthy, indeed, endeavor. University College, the College of Behavioral and Health Sciences, and the Metropolitan Nashville Police Department recently reached a very historic agreement that gives officers an incentive to get their degrees. Officers who complete the department's 5.5-month training academy can now potentially receive more than a year worth of college credit. MTSU announced a similar partnership this past spring, with the Tennessee Department of Environment and Conservation to give wastewater management workers opportunities for course credits and certification. Participation such as these and programs and initiatives such as these create more pathways for our students and others in industry to earn a college degree. There are many individuals that have been involved, many of our deans and administrators, but Dr. Peggy Carpenter has been most instrumental, particularly with the initiative with regards to the Metropolitan Police Department. Let's recognize those individuals, including Dr. Peggy Carpenter, for their great work that have brought great attention to this university. Also, I'm pleased to report to you several new academic programs have been launched just this past year. And I've heard the provost announced on a number of occasions publicly. I think MTSU over the last 5 to 10 years have developed more strategic, successful academic new degree programs in concentration than any other university in the state of Tennessee. But just this past year, we have new undergraduate degrees and concentrations in anthropology, history, international relations, philosophy, speech language pathology, and theater. New graduate approvals in liberal arts, library science, and finance, and a new MBA concentration approvals in music business and healthcare management. And we've created, under the leadership of the Dean of the College of the Jones College of Business and his colleagues, a new Flex MBA. It's a great example of adapting to the needs and expectations of our students and the citizens of this great state. Let's give all of our faculty and administrators a round of applause for great work this past year. In the area of advancement and fundraising, our efforts continue to bring valuable resources that support all areas of our university. And during the past fiscal year, gifts to MTSU, ladies and gentlemen, has exceeded $11 million, making the year 2015 one of the top 5 fundraising years in the university history. Support from our alums and friends helped with the establishment of new international scholarship program, major gifts to our Honors College and the College of Behavioral and Health Sciences, and made it the most successful year ever for the Blue Raider Athletic Association. With less than 6 months left in our centennial campaign, we have achieved many of the milestones that were set out, and many at the time, a few years ago, said it was impossible with the goal that the university set. We have not only reached those goals, but we have actually smashed it and moving forward. We're continuing, ladies and gentlemen, to increase financial support. The campaign has moved into a greater focus these past 6 months ahead of us. 6 months ahead of us, we are focusing on the needs of academic programs, departments, and we're continuing to build a culture of philanthropy among our alumni of all ages. We have also broadened our development team by increasing involvement and engagement of university leadership and our faculty partners. I'd like Mr. Joe Bills and his staff and his team to stand and be recognized for the outstanding year again in fundraising. Now, the compliance audit for our reaffirmation of accreditation by the Southern Association of Colleges and Schools Commission on Colleges will be submitted in the coming weeks. Importantly, the development of our new quality enhancement plan, and just let me add, if you do not know, have not heard about our QEP, I urge you to check the website that is supported by the Provost Office and make sure that as a member of this university community, you are aware of our efforts in reaching the quality standards set by SACS, and particularly the QEP. The plan, the QEP plan, branded as, quote, MT Engage, was announced to the campus in the fall of 2014. The MT Engage focus on providing professional development to faculty that help infuse existing courses with high impact, engaging pedagogy. The intended result is an increased ability by our students to use integrative and reflective thinking to enhance their academic engagement and to foster a university-wide culture of engaged learning, and finally, in the end, to improve student success on our campus as measured by retention and graduation. So again, I encourage you to read the current draft of the plan and to make suggestions so that we can produce the best QEP possible. Our QEP last reaffirmation process was identified by SACS as a national model. And in 3 or 4 of the annual meetings of SACS, our team was asked to present our QEP, the EXL, under Professor Jill Austin and others, were asked to be available to present to other universities around the southeastern region an example of one of the best in the nation. We want that to be the case again as we move forward with our reaffirmation. So I encourage you to be aware of that. Representatives of the SACS COC will visit our campus on March 2016 to review both our compliance audit and our QEP. We will then fully launch MT Engage in the fall of 2016. And without exaggeration, one of the individuals who have shown and have provided not only this term, but in the previous review of SACS, incredible leadership, been Ms. Faye Johnson from the Provost Office. She has been outstanding. I want to recognize, where's Faye? Mm. Also, I would like to recognize Dr. Diana Russ, Chair of our QEP Committee. Dr. Russ, would you stand? Let's recognize you. There she is. And finally, Professor Trish Farwell, for her work particularly with the MT Engage. Let's give her a round of applause. Today, I'm also proud to use this occasion to address and to acknowledge the success of our athletic department, both in the classroom and on the playing field during the previous academic year. The Blue Raiders won 2 Conference USA championships, had 3 teams advance to postseason play, had 4 athletes compete for national championships. The men's basketball team advanced to the league championship game last year. The baseball team won more games than any in one season since 2010. And our outdoor track finished 30th nationally. And our women's golf team won Conference USA championship and for the first time ever advanced to the NCAA regional appearance. Now, if you're not impressed with that, here are just a few more recent achievements by the MTSU student athletes in our athletic program. During the 2015 semester, 9 of our 17 athletic teams had a semester GPA of 3.0 or higher. 98 student athletes made the dean's list, GPA ranging 3.5 or higher. 37 student athletes achieved a perfect 4.0, and 170 of MT's total 312 student athletes had a GPA of 3.0 or higher, over 54%. And for the 6th consecutive year, all 17 Middle Tennessee athletic teams earned a multi-year academic progress report, APR, measured by the NCAA, of more than 930. The Blue Raiders had 10 of 17 sports with an APR of 970. The maximum is 1,000 or better. And men's and women's golf had a perfect score of 1,000. Football had an impressive multi-year score of 973. And 6 Blue Raiders scored reported perfect scores of 1,000 for the 2013-14 year. Baseball, women's basketball, women's cross country, men's golf, and volleyball. Very impressive as it relates to integrating academics and athletics on our campus. With Chris Massaro, and I know many of our coaches are up in the balcony, would you all stand and let's give you a round of applause for your commitment to excellence at this great institution. The MTSU campus facilities continue to be transformed and upgraded as the university implements its long-range plans aimed at providing students the best possible educational experience at a great value. The following projects are completed this past year or are currently underway. Renovation to the MTSU Old Science Buildings, Davis Science Hall and Weisler Patton Science Building are scheduled for completion by 2016. Full occupancy is anticipated for the spring of 2017 before the start of the semester. This major renovation will benefit all of the 11 departments in the College of Basic and Applied Sciences. They seem to be getting everything. You just gave them $147 million new science building. Dean Fisher, have you had enough? No. Figure to hear that. The Department of Physics and Astronomy will significantly expand its footprints on the floors of both buildings. Geosciences the newest department in the college will gain a new home. Formerly part of the College of Liberal Arts, it will relocate from Curcio, Maine to the second floor of Davis Science. This move will allow the expansion of the computer science department. Other completed ongoing projects this past year include the renovation of the McFarland building for the photography department, the opening of a new flight simulator building on our aerospace campus at the Murfreesboro Airport, the renovation of the Bell Street Center facility, which will house a new center for executive education in the Jones College of Business, the offices of the University College, the Center for Counseling and Psychological Services, and the College of Health and Human Performances, and the new Center for Chinese Music and Culture, along with some other programs that I'm sure Dean Whiteside will be announcing very shortly. And finally, on July 15th, the City of Murfreesboro and MTSU officials unveiled a long-anticipated Adams Indoor Tennis Complex, an 8-court facility that greatly enhances the Blue Raider tennis team while increasing playing and tournament opportunities for area residents. The new $6.2 million facility, 70,000 square foot complex, which is at the Old Fort Park in Murfreesboro, is the latest partnership between the city, MTSU, and the nonprofit Christy Houston Foundation. Now, the past several years, I used to say the only guarantee applause in my speech was when I talk about the budget and when we had money to give salary increases. And unfortunately, the last couple of years, that has been minimum. This year, though, ladies and gentlemen, the new budget for this fiscal year included increased funding and funds for higher education based exclusively on the formula outcomes. Funds for higher education employee salary increases this year, ladies and gentlemen, would equate from the governor's budget, original budget, to 1.5% salary pool. As in previous years, the state appropriation will not fully fund the portion of the increase that's being mandated by the state. Let me make sure you understand it. So they've given us a recommended through the governor's budget 1.5%. A portion of that has been funded through the state appropriation, and there is a portion that the institution needs to find to complete that. At the June 2015 quarterly meeting of the Tennessee Board of Regents, tuition increases were approved to fund the institution's 1.5, and I'm pleased to report to you that the presidents of the university system have encouraged the board to add, because of the long years of minimal to no increases, we've asked and the board approve an additional 0.5%. So give me my deserved applause. You'll be getting 2% this year. We're still working for 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 10%, but right now it's 2%. That's being proposed. There's more. Hold on to your seats. The salary increases will be distributed to all unrestricted and restricted regular full-time and part-time benefit eligible employees and participants in the post-retirement service program on the payroll as of June 30th. Now, eligible employees will receive an increase equal to 2% in their June 30th salary, or $750, whichever is greater. The minimum payment will be prorated for part-time employees. However, and I should say unfortunately, due to the limited funds, these increases will not apply to adjunct faculty, temporary employees, graduate assistants, or student workers. Now, I realize that we must do something. It's been years since we have addressed the issue with adjuncts, part-time, and our student and graduate assistants. And I hope that someday, as resources become available, that we can address those issues. So if my recommendation is approved by TBR at its September quarterly meeting next month, increases will be effective, so don't go and spend it right now. It'll be effective in your October pay period. The good news is that it'll be retroactive to July 1. I was about to take that retroactive out, and but I think you earned it. Now, as we all know, the Tennessee new funding formula for higher education implemented in 2011 places the highest priority on student progress, matriculation, and graduation successes. We are no longer funded based on the number of students enrolled. Those are days gone by. We're in a new normal. Our funds are exclusively based and appropriated on the success, the outcomes. Governor Bill Haslam's Drive to 55 initiative seeks to improve the state's workforce by increasing the percentage of Tennesseans with post-secondary degrees or certificate up to 55%. In last academic year, we made great strides in helping our students stay enrolled and on a clear path to earning their degrees. Significant progress was made. Our achievements can be largely attributed to our very ambitious Quest for Student Success initiatives, which has proven to be an effective roadmap in the effort to improve retention and graduation. Ladies and gentlemen, with the first 6 months of implementing the Quest, the first 6 months, just two components we implemented in the first 6 months. First, a new advising model, and second, a predictive analytics software system to better monitor students' progress. Since the implementation of those two, in the first 6 months, we have seen significant increases in students' persistence. Here are some of the specific results from last academic year. Persistent rates increased by 2.2% for new freshmen, 4.5% points for transfer students, and 2.1% for sophomore students. These improvements, if you think these are insignificant percentages, these improvements resulted last spring in approximately $1.5 million in additional revenue and resources for this university. And we were just beginning. The future indeed looks bright, and I'm pleased to report to you today, we are currently on pace for an increase in our enrollment of new undergraduate students. And although official data will not be available until census on September 7th, the trends projection that we are monitoring have consistently indicated that MTSU will achieve a record or near record retention increases in the upcoming semester for first-time freshmen, new transfer students, and sophomore students. There's no question with this data that the Quest is helping to redefine and refocus our efforts and investment in classroom teaching, recruitment, and advising to better meet the needs of our students. And with the broad-based support from the university and its administrative team, led by Provost Brad Bartel, and Dr. Rick Sluter, Vice Provost of Student Success. And with the oversight of our academic deans, department chairs, and faculty, and our vice presidents, our plan is now showing tangible results. And ladies and gentlemen, we believe that there are several new initiatives that are driving these increases, including the redesign of more than 20 courses that have enhanced the learning experience of students, enabling them to better master the materials and offering a greater chance for success. Let it be said again and again, this is not about compromising academic standards. This is not about lowering grades. This is not about giving away degrees. It's about helping those students who are committed, dedicated, and want to be successful, working with those students to help them achieve their success. And we all hope by the close of the 2015 year, 28 courses have been through some form of redesign. 11 of MTSU's top 12 most predictive academic courses of student success, that most of our students enrolled in, will have been redesigned under the leadership of our deans, department chairs, and our faculty. For the last several years, I've used this occasion to recognize a particular department with the President's Student Success Award. I've awarded to recognize innovation and proven results in helping students succeed. And if you recall, last year, it was given to the Mathematical Science Department. And I believe that this year, the team that we will honor today measures up to the high standards and results put forward by our previous honorees. So ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure and an honor to announce that the team, the group that will receive the President's Award for 2015 for Student Success, led under direction of our academic deans and department chairs, and Dr. Sluter, our Vice Provost. Am I holding you along? Are you on the edges here? And nominated by the Provost to me, the academic advisors of this great university, I'd like to honor them with the President's 2015 Award. Would you all stand, those of you who are in the audience? This award does come with a monetary gift that we will give to your departments for support of your work for professional development. And I want to say to the audience that the recent hiring of the 47 new academic advisors more than doubled our advising team. And as a result, we have greatly enhanced our ability to effectively address the area of critical advising and academic support needs of our students. The new advisors join a dedicated group of veterans advisors to support our Quest initiative. From October 2014 through April 30th, 2015, the first 6 months of assistance use, let me give you a sense of the accomplishment of this group. As a group, they met in person with 19,464 students. They conducted over 5,727 advising sessions by email or online. They advised 772 students by phone. They reviewed the files of 12,627 students and reached out to assist them. And altogether, they made 40,206 contacts with students. That's a heck of a lot of work. Let's give it another round of applause. I must say that these early successes have not gone unnoticed, and publications and peers around the country have spoken. An article in the March 13 Chronicle of Higher Education noted that MTSU is at the forefront nationally of efforts to improve retention and graduation. MTSU student success efforts also pointed out in a nationally special report in the Washington Post in June of this year. And most impressively, we just were informed a few weeks ago that the APLU, the most prestigious association of higher education in the nation, the Association of Public and Land Grant Universities, having received application, the provost informs me, about 600 applications from around the country, that association has named MTSU as one of five national finalists for its Project Degree Completion Award, recognizing the institutions that employ innovation and innovative approaches to improve student success. So others have recognized, have realized that there's something special going on this university, and I salute our advisors again for their outstanding work. Clearly, ladies and gentlemen, the university is committed to the success of every student, and we have committed considerable resources to making MTSU to continue to be and build on as a success-oriented institution. However, the interactions you have in your classrooms, offices, centers, around campus, and as you encounter students, those interactions form the basis of everything that we do at this university. So I encourage you, I urge you, to take a look at your own students and classes and settings and ask yourself, what can I continue to do to make this experience a better one for those students who are making the effort? Make it more meaningful and more effective in achieving their success. So I ask you to help take us to that next level of achievement. Much more can be done. I hope you've been impressed as the evidence is laid out of the success. We're just not saying we are a good institution. The evidence is there. And it's you, faculty, the staff, the administrators, you are making the difference in this great institution. It's the reason I get up excited every day as I approach my task as a president. And I want to thank each of you for the incredible work that you do in making this institution a leader locally, statewide, nationally, and internationally. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful new academic year. I look forward to working with you. Thank you so much.